The final step is to check and see if we've got any results from our ACE calculation. And I've opened up Process Book. Before I build a trend, though, I want to check two things just to make sure. The first thing I'm going to check is to open up my Windows Services applet. I've put a shortcut on my quick launch bar for that. And I want to scroll down to my Pi ACE schedule applications. And I want to make sure they're both running. And they are both running. So I'm okay with the ACE scheduler and the services running. And the other thing you may want to check is the ACE manager. I know we haven't talked too much about it yet, but it's under Pi System and it's called Pi ACE Manager. And what this is going to do is tell you the status of your calculations or your modules that you've created. And the scheduler version that is invoked when we open up ACE Manager is version 2. If you remember, I created the calculation in Visual Basic 6, which is ACE Scheduler version 1.x. So I need to change, I need to toggle the 1x, 2x under the server menu. And you'll notice that when I do that, I do have an ACE calculation here, and it is running. And if I drill down through my tree, I can see that I've got an ACE calculations calculation here, an executable. My module first calc is running, and the context of that calculation is my localhost Pi server train 56. And you can see I do have my trigger is set as the tag definition. Schedule type is natural. And we'll talk a little bit more about this ACE manager, but essentially what I want to look for is this status of on, and you'll see that the icons, if you look at them very carefully, and you have a good color on your monitor, you can see the little green outlines next to the Pi symbol here. That tells me that the ACE manager knows that these modules and executables are running. So now that I'm confident that everything is running correctly, I can go in and create a new display file very quickly and draw a trend on the screen. I will do a tag search for my BA tags. There's my BA temp and my BA temp 1 Fahrenheit. I will click OK. And let's go back over the last 1 hour to look at those tags. And in fact, I do see that while I've got a long history with my BA temp 1 tag, I do have some history that's been generated over the past few minutes while we've been talking about ACE. My BA temp 1 underscore Fahrenheit is being generated as well. And you can see that it is tracking right along with my input tag. And if I were to go into the database and the archive, I would see that the timestamps would match up as well. So every time I get a value in for BA temp, I calculate a value for BA temp Fahrenheit.